Good morning, students. I welcome you all for our English class of today. Have you prepared the first unit? Do you have any doubt in it? So then and there, prepare your lessons well. Right, children? All right. Before going to our lessons, I wanted to tell you one incident which happened in Italy. Once one teacher was taking class in the Italian school, and all the children's attention was diverted somewhere else. They were looking through the window and they were not at all listening to the class. The teacher, for some time she was just teaching, and since she found out that the children were not concentrating on her class, she went out and looked what is there beyond that window. And the teacher found out that a small boy was sitting in near the window. He was not well dressed. From his outward appearance, the teacher understood that he is a poor boy. And the teacher got angry since the children were not listening to her. So she scolded the child and told him to go away from that place. The child said, "I'm just sitting here simply and listening to your class. I'm not disturbing anyone." The teacher said, "In that case, from tomorrow onwards, you can come and sit in my class and listen. You can come here to study." But the boy said, "I have no money to pay fees to the school." And the teacher felt a little pity towards that particular boy and asked him, "If that is the case, let me ask you certain questions. You have been listening to the class for one period. So I'll be asking certain questions to you. If you answer, let me see whether you could answer or not." The teacher asked questions that was completed in that particular period. The child excellently answered the teacher. So she was extremely happy and told this boy, "You need not worry about anything, about the fees or other facilities. You just, from tomorrow onwards, you come to our school to study. I will take care of the fees," the teacher said. And the child came to school, studied regularly, and he has later in his life, he has become just landed, made a footprint in the sands of Italian country. And he is no other person except Ludovico Antonio Muratori. So what do you learn from this small incident, children? He's a historian, famous Italian historian, thinker, scholar, and he's a writer, philosopher also. So from this we could understand that if you have a willingness, the circumstances is not the problem at all. Where there is a will, there is a way. If you have a willingness to study, if you have a willingness towards your work, there is way for it. Don't blame the other things. It is of no use. Now let us come back to our lessons. The second unit poem, "Our Casuarina Tree," written by Toru Dutt. "Our Casuarina Tree" by Toru Dutt. Have you seen this casuarina tree in our area? Mostly this tree is found in southern India and Australia. It is, in Tamil we call it as chavukku maram. And mostly in this zoo near Trivandrum, I think we could see this casuarina tree. In other places also, it is a common tree. Right. And this, let me tell you something about this Toru Dutt. She was a Bengali poet. She was born in Bengal. She belongs to the 19th century. An Indian writer in English. an Indian writer in English. She is a very famous writer, poetess, and unfortunate thing is, she died at the very young age of 21. About her family lives in Bengal. Her father, mother, as well as one brother and one sister she has got, and they were all very intelligent people. She belongs to a high-class Hindu family in Bengal. And every one of her family is very intelligent, educated people. At the age of 14, she lost her brother. And she is the youngest of the three, and she lost her brother at the age of when he was 14. And after that, she along with her sister, they went to France, Italy and England and got their education. She was, though she went to foreign countries, she has her own interest, faith, likeness towards her own native land. She studied French and got intimacy with the French people, and she wrote three books. The books came in three editions, but she was not there to witness any of her editions. Before that, she has passed away. She contributed a lot to the English literature. Though she is an Indian, she contributed a lot to the English literature. She left an imperishable legacy to us. We can say that she is the writer who belongs to the world. We cannot say that she is a Hindu, belongs to this caste or something like this. We cannot tell. She belongs to the world. Such a broad-minded personality she was. Right? Now, let us go to the poem. This childhood memories, this poem tells us about her childhood memories. See, our childhood memories are always nostalgic. We love to cherish them. We used to narrate them very often. Right? Toru that is also one among us who made her childhood immortal through her poem Our Casuarina Tree. She made her childhood immortal through her poem Our Casuarina Tree. This much I think is enough for our introduction about the poetess. Now let us go to the poem Our Casuarina Tree. Take your textbook, students. In page number 52 it is. Our Casuarina Tree by Toru Dutt. See in the next page, in page number 54, something is given about the author. Let us go through it. She was born in 1856 and she died at the age of, at the year 1877 at the age of 21. She was a Bengali poet from the Indian subcontinent. She wrote in English and French. She was the third daughter of the family. The Dutt family was a family of distinguished intellectuals and poets. She also had advantage of being taught by excellent English tutors at home and later on of the long stay in Europe and England. Toru, with all her exposure to and involvement in Western life and culture, loved the land of her birth and remained thoroughly Indian in her consciousness and sensibility. So though she has got her education abroad, the influence of foreign culture, she remained thoroughly an Indian. Besides her well-known collections of poems with the title Ancient Ballads and Legends of Hindustan, she has to her credit a volume of poems in French titled Sheaf Gleaned in French Fields. And our poem, the prescribed poem of us, Our Casuarina Tree, is taken from her miscellaneous poems. But she was not there to see the editions of this book. Our Casuarina Tree by Toru Dutt. Just see the introduction. Your visit, your you visit your school after several years. As you cross the banyan tree at the entrance, cheerful memories fill your mind. Fill in the bubbles with your memories. As you enter the school, you saw that gate, by the side of it, some neem trees, all these things. Your memories will be cherished. You will get someone, you will just recollect something. What all the things you will recollect? The teachers, principal, your classmates, your best friend. All these things comes, our playground, where we play very happily. All these things comes one by one into your mind. Let us see that. What the story that just tells us through this poem, our Casuarina tree. Take the book, children, 52 page number. Like a huge python winding round and round, a rugged tree indented deep with scars, up to its very summit near the stars. A creeper climbs, in whose embraces bound, no other tree could live. But gallantly the giant bears the scarf, and flowers are hung in crimson clusters all the boughs among, whereon all day are gathered birds and bees, and oft at nights the garden overflows with one sweet song that seems to have no close, sung darkling from our tree while men repose. So this first paragraph, I think you might have understood a little, right? It describes the tree. Maybe there is a tree in front of our Toru Dutt's home, the Casuarina tree. So now, in the first paragraph, she describes the tree. The description of the tree is given in the first paragraph. Like a huge python, snake. Mostly we will see it in the jungles, mountainous areas, right? What will it do? It just rolls around the person's body or and it kills that person, right? Just like that, this python just rolling round and around a person or something else, this tree, by the side of the tree, there are some creepers or something, some root winding round and round. This tree is engulfed by python, right? The rugged trunk, the very old trunk, is a part in between the root and the stem. The rugged trunk indented deep with scars. There are some scars here and there in the trunk of the tree. That shows that the tree is very old. A very big, gigantic tree it is. Up to its very summit near the stars, though the python is there, though there are deep scars on its body, the tree just went and touched the stars. It was very high. It is a very great tree with gigantic look. It just reaches the summit of the stars. A creeper climbs in whose embraces bound no other tree could live. There is a creeper. You know what is a creeper? You might have studied in botany. It creeps on something else to have its existence. So a creeper climbs and embraces the tree. It swallows the tree like, but no other tree could live. Because of the influence of the creeper, no other tree could withstand except the our Casuarina tree. So from here, she says that though the creeper is there, our tree is very strong and it grew high up in the sky. It touches the stars, she says. No other tree could live. If you take trees other than Casuarina tree, it will never withstand the embraces of the creepers and climbers. But gallantly, very bravely, very majestically, very heroically, the giant wears the scarf. The giant tree, the casuarina tree, wears the scarf. What is the scarf? And flowers are hung. So it is just having flowers, just like scarf, in crimson clusters. So how is, what is the color of that flowers which is hung from that tree? Crimson clusters, reddish flowers, in groups, attractive color. All the boughs among all the boughs are filled with flowers. It's a very beautiful tree, whereon all day are gathered birds and bee, and oft at night the garden overflows. And it is filled with flowers. Other than that, all the day we could see birds and bees on the trees. And it will be singing sweet songs. Bees will be collecting nectar from the flowers. And oft at night, the garden overflows with one sweet song. At night, you could hear one sweet song of a bird that seems to have no close. It is an endless song of the bird, sung darkling from our tree when men repose. When all the people take rest, when people sleep, this bird goes on singing, and just like a lullaby, it is just making the people sleep. Hope you understand the first poem, paragraph of the poem. So here she gives a vivid account of the casuarina tree. She describes the tree, how it is. Now look at the rhyme scheme of the poem. First line A, 2, B, third also B, fourth one again A, next C, next D, D, C, the last three lines E, E, E. A different rhyme scheme she has followed in this poem. Right? What is the rhyme scheme? A, B, D, A. C, D, D, C. E, E, E. Right? So, I told you the first paragraph is the description of the poem. Now, if you take this casuarina tree as our motherland, as our India, there are so many symbolic representations are used here. The tree represents our motherland. Our casuarina tree represents the motherland with a gigantic look. Our country has vast, very big country, having a vast area, gigantic figure it is. And the trunk on its body stands for the antiquity and culture of our country. The antiquity and culture of our country, the great trunk represents. And it has some scars on its body. It is said it has some, in the second line she says it is deep with scars. It may represent the past straits and tribulations, the invasions of so many countries over our India. So, past straits and tribulations that our country has undergone. Then, the python is the cultural invasions. Python is the cultural invasions that was given, that was made to our country, that was given to our country. So many people have invaded us. And especially the foreigners looked at our country as a land of pythons, snakes and magicians. Snakes and magicians. Now, creepers absorbed the foreign elements, but it maintained its own antiquity, its own image. Though creepers are there, it has its own image as India, its own culture, its own heritage. Now, scarf. Its scarf just hang like clusters, flowers just hang like scarf. It represents In India especially, the scarf is associated with modesty. In India, Indian culture, femininity is a symbolic of modesty. It tells us about the femininity of Indians, Indian girls. And the flowers represents the creepers and climbers that comes to our country to take away our riches. So, though it describes a tree which is there in front of our home, she symbolically describes our India through this poem in the first paragraph, in the description of the poem. Hope you understand the first paragraph. Like a huge python winding round and round, that rugged trunk indented deep viscous, up to its very summit near the stars, a creeper climbs in whose embraces bound no other tree could live. But gallantly the giant wears the scarf, and flowers are hung in crimson clusters all the boughs among, whereon all day are gathered birds and bees, and oft at night the garden overflows with one sweet song that seems to have no close, sung darkling from our tree while men repose in the state of rest at night. So she gave a vivid account of the tree. Now let us proceed to the next paragraph. When first my casement window is wide open thrown at dawn, my eyes delighted on its rest. Sometimes, and most in winter, on its crest a grey baboon sits statue-like alone, watching the sunrise, while on lower boughs his puny offspring leap about and play. And far and near, kogilas hail the day, and to their pastures wend our sleepy cows, and in the shadow on the broad trunk cast by the whole tree, so beautiful and vast, the water lilies spring like snow en masse. Right. When first my casement is wide open thrown, early in the morning when I open the windows of my room, at dawn, early morning, my eyes delighted on its rest. I was so delighted to see the casuarina tree. The very look of the tree make me feel pleasant, relaxed, happy. When first my casement means window, is wide open thrown, at dawn my eyes delighted on its rest. Sometimes, and most in winter, on its crest, very often, early in the morning, especially during the winter season, I could see at the topmost branch, I could see a grey baboon. Baboon, a large monkey. A monkey was sitting, every day I could see the monkey sitting at the top of the tree, in one branch. Majestically it will be sitting. What will it be doing? Watching the sunrise, while on lower boughs, his puny offsprings leap about and play. It was sitting and watching the sunrise. Early morning, if you see the sunrise, it will be a very beautiful sight for our eyes, feast for our eyes. You could see this in Kanyakumari very clearly, just coming out from the deep sea, right? So it was just watching the sunrise. While it is watching the sunrise, what is the offsprings of it doing? The young ones of this baboon does? It leap about and play. It will be just jumping from branches to branches, and very happily they will be playing. It will be a very beautiful scene to look at the tree in the morning. And far and near, kogilas hail the day. Around the neighboring places, in the neighboring trees, we could see small birds which is similar to cuckoo, which is famous for singing birds. Kogila is a singing bird. We could hear the sound of the kogila's singing. It announces that the day has dawned. And to their pastures went our sleepy cows, nearby pastures where the greeny grass is there. Our sleepy cows walk slowly towards the pastures for their food. And in the shadow on the broad tank cast by that oak tree, so beautiful and vast, the water lilies spring like snow and mast. By the side of it, you could see that in the tree is filled with snow, and there are water lilies which is there spread over the tree. And by the oak tree, so beautiful and vast, the water lilies spring like snow and mast. The water lilies look like the snow which is covering the tree. So here she says, describes, gives some more idea about the casuarina tree, right? How it will be. When she opens the door in the morning, window in the morning, she could see the baboon sitting there with the young ones and playing, and kogilas are singing, cows are just roaming about for the green pastures, and it is very beautiful to see the scenery early in the morning. Hope you understand the second paragraph, children. Here also the rhyme scheme of the poem is A, A, B, B, A, C, D, D, C, E, E, E. She followed a fixed pattern for this paragraph also. Right? Let me read it once and we will stop it. When first my casement is wide open thrown, at dawn my eyes delighted on its rest, sometimes, and most in winter on its crest, a grey baboon sits statue-like alone, watching the sunrise, while on lower boughs his puny offspring leap about and play. And far and near, kogilas hail the day, and to their pastures bend our sleepy cows, and in the shadow on the broad tank cast by that oak tree, so beautiful and vast, the water lilies spring like snow and mast. So many poetic devices are used by this poetess in this, you will see it later, right? Just go home, just open your book and read these lines again and again. Very interesting poem it is, and just prepare yourself by seeing the book, that book I asked you to buy. Okay, children, I will wind up this session. Thank you.